Hi, this is Donna. Welcome to rainydayguitar.com. Okay, today we're going to learn I Want a Hippopotamus for Christmas. You can go to rainydayguitar.com and print off the words and the lyrics and the chords above the song so that makes it easier to sing and keep the words straight and keep the chords straight too. Okay, we're going to keep this really simple. We're going to do this in G so we don't have any bar chords. And you can just kind of, there's lots of ways to play this. You can go down, 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 down. Or you can do on a G, six pluck, and I'm plucking one, two, and three at the same time. Six pluck, four pluck, six pluck, four pluck. That's my favorite, okay, because I'm a plucker, not a strummer. But if you're a strummer, knock yourself out. Okay, so I'm just going to go right into this and kind of walk you through it, and then we'll maybe put it on and play it with, big debate whether it was Shirley Temple and Gayla Peavy, but I think Gayla Peavy was the one who did it after a little bit of research. So here we go. I would do that intro four times. Six pluck, four pluck, six pluck, four pluck, six pluck, four pluck. I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. Only a hippopotamus will do. I'd probably go four, go to a D, and I'd aim for four pluck, five pluck, four pluck. Like if you miss, and like I just missed, to do five pluck, four pluck, five, that works too, okay? But I kind of like the bass notes first. Four pluck, five pluck, four pluck, five pluck, then go right to a D seventh and keep doing four pluck, five pluck. Don't want a dog, a dinky tinker toy. Oh, there's something fun you can do if you are strumming. Cool, huh? You can't really do that if you're plucking. What I did was I just moved everybody down into the first fret, but your second string is actually kind of open, so he's kind of moving up onto the white ridge there. Ha! Huh. Never done that before, but it sounds really cool. Look at that, that's kind of fun. I went down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, down, up. Can't do that if you're plucking. That's the only disadvantage, which I like to pluck, but I might do the strumming just for that. It's kind of hard to stick that in there. Let's see if maybe I can strum. Might be able to combine them. Let me see if I can do it gracefully. Never done this before. Oh, I'm gonna go back to only a hippopotamus will do. Don't wanna dance. Ah. Okay. Don't wanna dance. Why? Not very graceful. Okay. So then you go to a C and your bass note is five. I want a hippopotamus. Seventh, play with and enjoy. G, I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. I don't think Santa Claus will mind, do you? D seventh, so that's a D. He won't have to use no dirty chimney flue to bring him through the front door. Let's see, to bring him through the front door. That's the easy thing to do. So you went from a C to a D seventh, then you're going to go to a G seventh, six, five, and one. I can see me now on C, Christmas morning. Okay, so on G, your bass notes are six. You can go six, four, six, four. So six pluck, four pluck, six pluck, four pluck. And go to a C, five pluck, four pluck, five pluck, four pluck. Okay, by the way, if you don't know these chords, go to rainydayguitar.com and print them off. Super easy. They're under the beginning guitar chord little section there. Okay, so, I lost my place. I can see now on Christmas morning, creeping down the stairs. Oh, what joy and surprise. I don't know the melody right here. When I open up my eyes, then then an A, C, five-ish bass note, C, D, standing, then a D7, go back to a G, I want a hippopotamus for Christmas, only a hippopotamus will do, no, no crocodiles, no rhinoceroses, then a C, I only want D7, I only like D7. Hippopotamuses, C and hippopotamus, D7th. Musses like me, G2. Then you have a little interlude. Da 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 da. You're on G. Da 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 da. Then to a D. Da. Then you come in singing D7. Mom says the hippo. Witty me, I don't know the words that well. Mom says the hippo would eat me, would eat me up, but then, there we go, then a C. Teacher says the hippo is a D7 vegetarian. And you do that same interlude again with a G. There's lots of room for him in our two-car garage. A, I'd feed him there and mash him there, and then a D7th, give him his massage. I can G7. See me now on Christmas morning. G7th, creeping down the stairs. Oh, a D7th, joy, what surprise when I G. Play it with, as I was sitting there singing that, talking about the two-car garage. People didn't have a two-car garage when Shirley Temple was little, so I'm 100% certain now that this was not sung by Shirley Temple, but Gayla Peavy. So, because Shirley Temple, they didn't have two-car garages when she was little, so it couldn't have been her. Okay, let's go ahead and put this on. Here we go. Fun song for little kids. Here we go. Let's start on G.
D7.
sorry, D. Now D7. Hope your little kids enjoy this. Maybe it's the big kid in you that likes this song. You never know. I kind of do. Anyway, so, all right. Go to rainydayguitar.com where you can print out the music. Really helps to follow the words along. It's got the chords above. Lots of fun. I kind of doubt you're playing this for yourself. Probably you're playing this in a little family party or some little performance with little kids. If you're performing this, you're going to want to have the music in front of you because you always get a little nervous when people are watching. So anyway, go to rainydayguitar.com, print off the music, and there's more Christmas stuff there too. Thanks.